proud to introduce the Grand Lodge Chaplain, Edward Russell. In its publication and advertising, the Rosicrucian Order stresses the fact that it is not a religious organization. However, when we as individuals talk to non-members about the Order and its teachings, we soon find out that most people are firmly convinced that the Order is a religion, or at least is an offshoot or branch of some religious group. We wouldn't have this problem if the Order was a correspondence school teaching accounting or car repair, or even if it was something along the lines of a Dale Carnegie course. Our problem is caused by the fact that some of the teachings of the Order closely parallel much of what is contained in religion. And also, to a great extent, and out of necessity, we are forced to use the same terminology. To be able to convince the non-member that we are not a religion, we ourselves need to clearly understand just where we stand on this subject. In this discourse, we are going to discuss for a few minutes Rosicrucianism and religion. Man's attempt to relate himself to a divine cause is generally classified into three categories. These are religion, mysticism, and philosophy. For the purpose of this discourse, we will inject two minor categories, religious mysticism and mythical philosophy. Perhaps at this point it might be well if we looked at the accepted definitions of the three main terms. In order to save time, I have condensed the dictionary definitions while trying to keep intact the true meanings. Religion is first a quest for the values of the ideal life, involving three phases: the ideal, the practices for attaining the ideal, and the theology relating quest to the environing universe. Secondly, a specific fundamental set of beliefs and practices agreed upon by a number of persons or sects, generally including the belief in a deity or group of deities that has created the world and governs it, as well as the belief that ritual, prayer, and certain principles of everyday conduct are expedient and spiritually rewarding. This second definition is what is generally meant when we use the word religion. Mysticism is the doctrine of a direct union of the self or soul with a cosmic or divine cause. Philosophy is the study or science of the truth or principles underlying all knowledge and being. Basically and traditionally, the Rosicrucian Order is a mystical school, studying and teaching mysticism, with elements of both religion and philosophy. This is why we have injected the two minor categories mentioned earlier. Many persons have joined the Order after having gone fruitlessly from church to church in hopes of finding a teaching and way of life that would satisfy their inner longing. Such persons could almost be called refugees from religion. They find everything they want in the Order and come to look upon it as a spiritual home. In a sense, it might be said that many of these members make a religion out of the teachings. Others come into the Order and still keep up their active membership in a church. Such persons are still basically satisfied with the teachings of their particular religion. but wish to find additional knowledge which they cannot get in the church. It is because of this that we find the order, including in its membership, many ministers, not only of the Christian faith, but also from the Eastern religions. The Rosicrucian studies the teachings of those great leaders in whose name our modern religions have been founded. And although we do not consider them to be gods, we do recognize them as having evolved with such a high degree of mastership as to set them apart from other men. We believe that their teachings have contributed much to the spiritual evolvement of mankind. While we know that the moral codes found in religion are man-made, we are also aware of the fact that it is largely through the vehicle of religious teaching that mankind has been encouraged to live up to those codes. Stripped of their dogmatism, all religions are found to contain many elements of truth that are found in the Rosicrucian teachings. In the Rosicrucian monographs, we find many references to persons who are known as religious mystics. To mention just a few, Meister Eckhart, St. Augustine, Ramakrishna, and Thomas a Kempis. Many persons, while still within the confines of religion, have found that personal union with the cosmic as taught in mysticism. This explains why some of our members find belonging to a church and the order to be compatible. In fact, they would not be happy if they were to sever their relationship to the church. They are finding what they want in religious mysticism. There is a third type of member that should be mentioned. They seem to find in our teachings something that creates an inner conflict. Usually, they have been raised in one of the various denominations that holds its members through fear. Fear of the church and of God. Eventually, these members leave the order and retreat into what they consider to be the safety of their church. Mysticism, the search for a direct union with a divine cause, takes many forms. There are those who try to achieve such union by communing with nature. Others hope to find it solely through meditation. Perhaps the most unusual form of mysticism is that practiced by those persons who think that they will attain their goal of union with the cosmic forces by disciplining or torturing their bodies. Whether or not the persons who practice these various forms of mystical endeavor are successful depends upon the individual and is outside the realm of our present discussion. Fortunately, there is another method, that of studying the teachings of what were once called the mystery schools, one of which, of course, is our own beloved order. Sooner or later, serious students of mysticism will be drawn to philosophy, or the ontology of being. They will wish to study the nature of being itself. They will search for philosophical concepts to add to their knowledge of mysticism. And in time, will become what we have called mystical philosophers. At the far end of the scale, we find some of the so-called pure philosophers, those who have studied the science of being and formulated theories that reject all forms of theism or belief in a god or divine cause. These the Rosicrucian cannot accept in whole. And yet, we find much in the teachings of these men that is worthwhile and acceptable. Other philosophers have incorporated in their philosophy the theory of pantheism. That is to say, God in all things and all things in God. This pantheistic theory can be found in some religions as well as philosophy, and is largely compatible with Rosicrucianism. Now that we have taken a broad look at Rosicrucianism, let us narrow our inquiry and discuss those areas of religion with which we do not agree. There are three basic tenets of most religions. These are belief in an anthropomorphic God, separateness of God and man, and divine salvation. We will take these three points in order. Most contemporary religion is based upon the belief in an anthropomorphic God, that is, a God who has attributes generally ascribed to a human being. They speak of an angry or jealous God. At other times, God is called a divine father, dispensing gifts or punishment according to the moment. Further, man is said to have been made in the image of God, who is portrayed as being some sort of Superman whose total interest is in that part of creation which resembles him. If we go back a few thousand years and look at the knowledge available to man at that time, we can understand their having such a concept. They believed that the Earth, this planet upon which we live, was the center of the universe. It was thought that the sun and the stars were placed in the sky solely for man's benefit. Today, we know that we are such a small part of the universe that we cannot comprehend its totality. And therefore, the concept of an Earth-centered universe is no longer considered valid. The second tenet of religion with which Rosicrucianism differs is closely identified with the first. It is a concept that man and God are separate entities. Religion gives us the picture of God that is the creator of all things, who then stands aside and watches his creation. Rosicrucianism, on the other hand, teaches that God, or the cosmic, is in all things. We are taught that the real man, the inner man, is a part of God, that all men, whether they realize it or not, have within themselves a part of that essence, the whole of which is God. We do not place ourselves apart from God, but believe that we are a physical manifestation of the God force. All things are a part of God. However, we think that we, as human beings, are unique in that we are aware of this fact, which sets us apart from animals and inanimate objects. The third point of most religious dogma, with which the Rosicrucian teachings do not agree, is what is called absolution from sin, or divine salvation. This concept is not taught by all contemporary religions, but to us in the Western part of the world, it is the principle we most encounter in religious teachings. Most of the Western religions teach that man can escape the result of his actions by one or more of three methods: prayer by man himself, by a mediator such as a priest or minister interceding for him, or by divine intervention. it is taught that man can be saved from his so-called sins by expressing a belief in a particular God, or by conforming to a rigid set of beliefs and customs that have been laid down by some church or religious body. Rosicrucianism, on the other hand, teaches that each act, each thought, whether good or bad, sets in motion a force that must end in a result in which we, who initiated the force, must share. We call this the law of cause and effect, and we do not believe that we, or anyone acting in our behalf, can set aside this law. In summing up what we have discussed in this discourse, we find that the teachings of the order contain elements of religion, mysticism, and philosophy. While we do not confine ourselves within the doctrines of any particular theology or system, we do search for the values of the ideal life and practices for attaining such values. Mysticism, or the doctrine of direct union with the cosmic, is one of the fundamental teachings of the order. Beyond that, we delve deeply into the study of ontology, or the science of being. And so, we find the Rosicrucian order occupying a central position. Rosicrucians, while recognizing the basic truths underlying religion, go beyond religion. Through mysticism, they find union with the cosmic or God, and finally learn to grasp of great concepts known to us as philosophy.